Hey guys, welcome to my new Let's Play of Halo Combat Evolved. So I'm playing this through the Xbox One and I'm using the Elgato HD60S capture card, which is really nice because it allows 1080p and 60 frames per second. So hopefully this is going to look really nice. I'm still setting up my new microphone, so this is the first time I've recorded with the Elgato, so I'm hoping it's going to come out okay, but like I said, bear with me until I get all the settings just right. So without further ado, let's kick off the first level, the Pillar of Autumn. Let's go with that. I'm going to do it on normal. I've done it on legendary. To be honest, I've played this game dozens and dozens of times. It's the reason I bought the original Xbox back in 2001 or two. I have completed it on legendary. I'm going to do it on normal for the Let's Play so that I don't spend hours and hours on some levels trying to survive. So, right, let's kick off. Yeah, that's fine. I'm going to stay quiet for the cutscenes because I absolutely love them and the soundtrack's amazing and it's just one of my favourite games.
Cortana, all I need to know is, did we lose them?
I think we both know the answer to that.
We made a blind jump. How did they...
get here first? The Covenant ships have always been faster. As for tracking us all the way from Reach, at light speed my maneuvering options were limited.
We were running dark, yes?
Until we decelerated, no one could have missed the hole we tore in subspace. They were waiting for us on the far side of the planet.
So, where do we stand?
Our fighters are mopping up the last of their recon picket now, nothing serious. But I've isolated approach signatures for multiple CCS-class battle groups. Make it 3 capital ships per group. And in about 90 seconds, they'll be all over us.
Well, that's it then. Bring the ship back up to Combat Alert Alpha. I want everyone at their station.
Everyone, sir?
Everyone. And Cortana.
Hmm?
Let's give our old friends a warm welcome.
I've already begun.
Attention, all combat personnel. Please report to your action station. Platoon, secure airlocks on deck 11. 14th platoon, rendezvous with 22nd tactical at Bolthead Charlie 14.
You heard the lady. Move like you got a purpose.
This is not a drill. I repeat, this is not a drill.
Once again, it is our job to finish what the flyboys started. We are leaving this ship, platoon, and engaging the Covenant on solid ground. When we meet the enemy, we will rip their skulls from their spines and toss them away laughing. Am I right, Marines?
Sir, yes, sir!
Mm-hmm. Damn right I am. Now move it out. Double time.
Attention all personnel. We are re-engaging the enemy. External and internal contacts imminent.
All you greenhorns who wanted to see Covenant up close, this is gonna be your lucky day.
Sir? Right. Let's thaw him out. Okay. Bringing low-level systems online. Cracking the case in 30 seconds.
Attention
He's hot! Blowing the pins in five!
It's just a brilliant opening cutscene.
Well, Master Chief, things are a little hectic right now. The disorientation should pass quickly.
Welcome back, sir. We'll have your battle-ready stat.
What I forgot to
Chief,
say in
the... Around the room.
Oh,
I need
okay,
to
I'll just wait.
Reading for your battlesuit's diagnostics.
What I forgot to mention in the opening cutscene, this is the Master Chief Edition, so it's the remastered Halo Combat Evolved, as you can probably tell.
Thank you, sir.
I'm bringing your health monitors online, sir.
Vital signs look normal. No freezer burn. Okay, sir. Go ahead and climb out of the cryo tube. I gave you a double dose of the wake-up stim. Take a quick walk around the cryo bay and join me at the optical diagnostic station when you're ready.
Now, it does have, so we can change to the old textures. So this is what the original game looked like. So this is absolutely how you remaster a game. And for obvious reasons, I'm going to play it in the remastered, but yeah, this is quite nostalgic.
I know the ordnance techs usually take care of your targeting sensors, but we're short of time, Chief. Just look at each of the flashing panels to target them. When you lock on, it'll change color. Okay, that looks good.
I'm ready for the energy shield test now.
Please follow me to the energy shield test station.
Give me a gun, damn it.
Defensive positions Alpha and Sierra. Sensors show inbound Covenant boarding craft. Stand by to repel borders.
Come on then.
Stand on the yellow square. This will just take a second.
Let's get my shields online.
Bring his energy shields online, please.
All right. Shields read as fully charged.
Okay, sir. Bring them down to test the automatic recharge.
Oh, that noise brings back fear. Memories of fear.
Recharging normally. We're showing green across the board.
Good. Right, get me a gun.
This is Captain Key. Send the Master Chief to the bridge immediately.
Captain, we'll have to skip the weapons diagnostics and
I... double, crewman.
Aye, aye, sir.
Don't argue with Captain Keyes.
We'll find you weapons later.
Okay, I'll leave the self-diagnostics running at least. Oh god, they're trying to get through the door!
Oh no!
Intruders in Cryo 2!
Sam! Come on, we've got to get the hell out of here!
So this is our first glimpse of these Covenant that have been chasing us through space.
Alert, all
hands. Whoa! Hello? Yeah, I don't think he's very well. Right, so use A to jump over. Looks like we're gonna have to make our way there ourselves. How inconvenient. And whoa, things exploding and shit.
I'm a cowardly boy.
Doors sealing around us. Right, let's crouch down. Yeah, they don't look very friendly. Maybe this is their way of just saying hello. Right, let's go through here. Whoa! I haven't got a gun. Give me a gun, damn it. Take me to the bridge. Okay, I guess I'm showing myself the way. Oh, right. Yeah, I mean, again, a reason I wanted to play this is...
ASAP! Better follow me!
Okay, just don't die this time. I hadn't seen... I follow quite a lot of YouTubers that do Let's Plays, and I hadn't seen any of them do it, and I thought, well, I'll give it a go. Yeah, I decided to start with Final Fantasy IX because it's a bit easier. I've got to get used to the sort of talking and gaming at the same time, so, I mean...
Waiting for, sir.
Final Fantasy is quite an easy one to start with because you're not really engaged in combat a lot. So I'm, you know, conscious that I'll spend ages concentrating and I won't have said anything for minutes and minutes at a time. So hopefully again I'll get better as I go along.
Good to see you, Master Chief. Things aren't going well. Cortana did her best, but we never really had a chance.
A dozen Covenant superior battleships against a single Halcyon class cruiser. With those odds, I'm content with three. Make that four kills. Sleep well?
No thanks to your driving, yes.
So you did miss me.
Report!
You must have been one of their boarding parties. I'd guess an antimatter charge.
Ma'am! Fire control for the main cannon is offline!
Captain, the cannon was my last offensive option.
All right, then. I'm initiating Cold Protocol Article 2. We're abandoning the Autumn. That means you too, Cortana.
While you do what? Go down with the ship?
In a manner of speaking. The object we found, I'm gonna try and land the Autumn on it.
With all due respect, sir, this war has enough dead heroes.
I appreciate your concern, Cortana, but it's not up to me. The protocol is clear. Destruction or capture of a shipboard AI is absolutely unacceptable, and that means you're leaving ship. Lock in a selection of emergency landing zones, upload them to my neural lace, and then sort yourself for a heart transfer.
Aye, aye, sir.
Which is where you come in, Chief. Get Cortana off this ship. Keep her safe from the enemy. If they capture her, they'll learn everything. Force deployment, weapons research, Earth.
I understand.
The Autumn will continue evasive maneuvers until you initiate a landing sequence. Not that you'll listen, but I'd suggest letting my subroutines handle the final approach.
Excellent work, Cortana. Thank you. Are you ready?
Yank me.
Good luck, Master Chief.
Your architecture isn't much different from the Autumn's.
Don't get any funny ideas.
Oh, Cortana's so awesome.
So you'll have to find ammo as you go.
Okay, so now we've got a gun and no ammunition. Right, get off the Pillar of Autumn. So that's my light. So he was mentioning. Oh, we've got some rounds. Okay, I'm a bit rusty with FPSs, so you'll have to bear with me if I end up sort of missing a lot, but I need to just reload. I might need to change these buttons around. Oh, there we go, okay. Oh, nice, right, so.
Those Marines could use some help, Chief.
Damn right they could. God damn it. Right, yeah, the elites are pretty tough. Right, oh gosh, okay. Have we got any grenades? No, we don't have any grenades. And the grunts are annoying. Yeah, as you've probably noticed, they've got shields as well. Or at least the elites have. Which are those big blue ones. And the grunts are fairly weak, but they do damage. What's my melee button on this? Press RB to reload, Y to switch weapons. You can carry two weapons at one time. Okay. Yeah, like I said, it's been quite a while since I've played it, but I have played it dozens and dozens of times. Doesn't sound good. So we're gonna try escape. Hell yeah. We're gonna swap the pistol out because we can use the Covenant weapons. They use plasma based weapons.
Did something just hit us?
Whoa, what was that?
Back to the airlock.
Oh crap, his stuff about to board. Where are they coming in? Yeah, so and these are much more effective against shields. But they do have a cooldown, so you can... Oh, wow, my shield. Yeah, as you can see, they rip through shields. So obviously, human weapons have the disadvantage of...
Code airlocks to attach their boarding craft. We go out and they come in.
So that's an overshield. Yeah, like I was saying, obviously human weapons have to be reloaded. Covenant weapons have a battery, so they don't need to be reloaded, but they do overheat. So it's a trade-off of whether you want, come on, weapons that you don't need to reload but can overheat, or good old-fashioned metal. So I've got my lights. Yeah, I just love this game. Like I said, it brings back a lot of memories from I was doing my A-levels when it first came out, so I guess an idea of how old I am, I guess. And yeah, I got it on the Xbox One. I got it on the original Xbox. And I remember finishing a maths class, running out of ammo. Yeah, I remember finishing a maths class and then going into town to buy it, to buy the Xbox and get Halo. Right, we'll swap that out because that one's dead. Yeah, and I loved it. Like I said, well, this is what the original looked like, but back then this was amazing. And you can see how they've... I like on the... You can notice at the front of the plasma rifle that in the old one there was just kind of two bits of shiny blue, but now you've got that plasma arc. So yeah, it's just they've really done well. And the music, the soundtrack is fabulous. I remember I had a CD player at the time where you could set... it was one of those multi-changer ones. And you could set it to... play a particular CD and a particular track at a certain time, so I used it as an alarm. And I had the Halo soundtrack, and I just had that as my alarm, like the opening soundtrack to wake me up. Still epic start of the day. Right, let's get some. Let's not dick around. Sometimes you just need a bit of metal. So yeah, like I said, that these are overshields, so they boost my shield. It doesn't recharge once it's worn down, but it does give me an extra two layers of shield, which is really handy. So yeah, they're doing a number on the ship. I can just provide some covering fire. So yeah, these elites, so these little guys are called grunts, and these bigger blue ones, or there's blue and red, they're different ranks, I think, are elites. And I've read all the books, they're really good as well. Just, I love the whole universe. You know, if you're a sci-fi nerd like me, it's a really good universe to immerse yourself in. Yeah, and you get a lot of backstory behind. So we're playing a Spartan called Master Chief. Yeah, so we're playing a genetically engineered human called Master Chief 117, I think. If I've got that wrong, that's like an absolute noob error to make. I'm sure he's number 117. And in the expanded universe, you find out about this Spartan program, and it's really good. I'd highly recommend all the books. There are some that I haven't read that are on my to read list. But I think probably one of my favourites was Ghosts of Onyx. I've got to read the Cole Protocol. Yeah, there's a graphic novel, there's just so much but it's really, really good. I really enjoy it. So yeah, I'm not sure how long these videos are going to be, because they're sort of convenient places to end. So yeah, they might be a bit long, but yeah, you know, I'm kind of, whoa, there's lots of... Yeah, it's good just to, you know, I love that. The assault rifle, you can just spray ammo, you can just spray bullets everywhere. Now you can both one-shot kill if you walk up behind an enemy, but you can also be one-shot killed if they sneak up behind you and melee you in the back of the head. So yeah, there's plenty of health packs at the beginning. Now I can't remember.
We should hurry.
I think they did away with health in Halo 2 because there are points in this where you can get stuck, because if you get to a checkpoint. Oh, excuse me.
Follow the nav point. It'll lead you to an opening.
Sorry, I talked all over Cortana then. Yeah, there are points in this where if you go to a checkpoint, you've only got one bar of health. You can kind of get stuck because there are some sort of points where you've got a lot of tough enemies. And so I think in Halo 2 they kind of did away with health. So once you're once your sort of shield was flat, you'd have maybe two or three shots and then you would die, rather than having this health system, which kind of did work out for the best, because I did find myself in
detecting Covenant movement outside the access ways. Activating motion tracker. Let's find a safe exit.
Oh, finally, yeah, we've got, so down in the bottom left now, we've got our motion sensor.
We need to find another route. Motion tracker shows all clear.
Oh, okay, well, I'm going out this way anyway.
Wait. We need to get through that door, but it's been damaged by an explosion. Analyzing. The door's control mechanism is offline, but it's taken a lot of damage. You should be able to bash it open with the butt of your weapon.
Oh, okay, so, right, now we've got melee. Yeah, I forgot there were sort of points in the story where it teaches you. Yeah, so like it says, melee attacks are silent and instantly kill enemies when you attack from behind. So if we go up and boom! Yeah, so I did find myself in points in the game where I was like really struggling to continue. Because I had so little health, and yeah, they can just rip through your shield. Let's run that flat. So let's wait for my shield to recharge. I might swap the buttons around before the next episode, because I'm getting confused with reloading being the right trigger button. Okay, so that's good. Yeah, I would probably say Halo 2 was my least favourite of the franchise. It was, I think, late being released, and it just felt too short. Oh, hello.
It looks like
you can't get me. Yeah, too late. So yeah, this is where the guy got shot when we were down there having our equipment set up. And again, let's just take a look. So this is what it looked like before. And this is what it looks like now. I'm probably going to show a bit on every level of what it used to look like before. Just so we can appreciate how well it has been remastered. So they're currently working on a remastered Skyrim, so take note, guys, this is how that you should be doing it. But I'm not entirely sure of the point of that, because if you've got the Steam version, you can just add better graphics mods, so I don't know if they're just going to integrate some of those mods into the game. I really don't want to pay more. The thing with Skyrim is it's such a big game that I end up playing it and then forget what I'm doing, and I've spent 40 hours getting to that point. And yeah, it's a case of, you know, do I really want to, you know, start again from scratch? But I might do a playthrough of it. So, I mean, it's always best to try and take out the, well, my tactic normally is to take out the grunts first, because they're the weakest, so they can still do a lot of damage with their plasma pistols to our shields, so where are you hiding? My motion tracker says you're over here somewhere, but I saw you run off this way. Yes, I am going to kill you all. You've wrecked.
The superstructure is expensive. I don't know how much more of a use the Autumn can take.
You're wrecking my favorite ship. Well, one of my favorite ships. Wow, it's taking a beating.
Keep your head down there.
Whoa.
Remember?
Okay. Let's swap that out. Wait for my shields to recharge. Yeah, they're quite slow to recharge in this one. There's a definite progression of technology in the games as well, which is good. I mean, during a war, there's obviously going to be, they're going to be focusing on trying to get much better weapons to... I mean, the Covenant at this point can really... there's not much competition in terms of, humans can't really put up much of a fight. The ships don't last very long against their plasma. I mean, the big ships have plasma cannons. Ah, so we've got some grenades. What is the button for grenades? Ah, use it. Oh, of course. Okay. Alright, let's chuck a grenade down. The Covenant ships have plasma cannons on them, and the human ships really don't stand much chance against them, so... And yeah, you really get a sense of that in the books. Oh, where is it? Okay, that's just the tunnel. Where is this escape pod? Down this way. It's just really, really good. Where is this bloody escape pod, Cortana? Oh, okay. I guess we just have to wander around.
Now would be a very good time to leave.
Point it.
Sir, I don't want to die out here.
Look!
What is that thing, Lieutenant?
Hell if I know. We're landing on it.
The Autumn! She's been hit!
I knew it. The Autumn's accelerating. Keyes is going in manual. Had fingers, they'd be crossed.
Okay, so that's the first episode done. I think that's probably a good place to leave it. So in the next episode, we will resume, now that we've crash-landed on this Halo ring world, and we'll gather our senses and see where to go from there. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode, guys, and I will see you next time.